This racist choosing beggar has just rejected a construction worker because he believes he can get it for cheaper. But when he comes crawling back, our construction worker has the last laugh as he now holds all the power. Happy birthday, today's your birthday, and on with the revamped show. So I have a couple of different jobs, but one includes being part of a real estate and development company. Basically construction for higher end clients. Most of work is based on referrals, so I don't get too many choosing beggars. Some basic background information. This is New York City. Choosing beggar hit me up because Ant, the referrer, told them about the great work we do. When I gave them a quote $8,000 to do some minor work in their apartment, Choosing Beggar said my offer was a ripoff, and he had someone upstate that could do it for $4,500. I told him good luck, and it wasn't worth it for me at that price. It's been about 2 months and I just heard back. This is all over a phone call that lasted like 30 minutes. He called me at 6:45 a.m.
Hi, this is Ant's friend again, and wanted to touch base about the work we discussed previously.
Sure, what do you need?
I need you to come finish the job for me. My guy is having issues and won't be able to finish. The job is half finished.
Okay, sure. I'll have to take a look at what he's done so far and send a new proposal over.
He already did half the job. Can't you just do it for half the price?
Well, first of all, there are fixed costs that come into project whether it's 0% completed or not. Those are not adjustable. Second, I can't just promise you to cut my price in half without seeing the project. I originally bid $8,000, so blindly cutting it to $4,000 wouldn't make sense on my end.
What? $8,000? The job is halfway done. My guy only charged $4,500. Most I can give you another $2,500, considering I gave 50% up front.
His prices and payment collection have nothing to do with me. There is no another $2,500. We never made a deal.
I texted you pictures of the job progress. Look it over and stop giving me such a hard time. I saw the work you did for Ant at his home. It was a way bigger project and it was for so cheap.
Ant has no business sharing my prices, nor are you entitled to his prices. I looked over your pictures. Whoever you hired did a decent job, but I would never sign off on that work. I sent over my proposal, which includes demolishing and starting over from scratch.
The price is $12,000? You can't be serious. You are not breaking anything. I want you to finish as is, not to start off. I think you're having a hard time understanding what I'm asking for.
I won't sign off on that work. I either start from scratch or I'm not interested in this job.
Why are you being so difficult with this? I am happy with how it's coming out. It is not your concern to tell me whether you like the work or not.
When I do a project, it is forever attached to me. I don't want that junk attached to me.
Junk? I seriously think you're overrating how good your work is. My guy did not do that bad of a job.
So have him finish it.
He can't work in the building anymore. The management kicked him out for lack of insurance and proper documentation.
When I originally bid on this job, Choosing Beggar tried to tell me insurance doesn't matter in his building, and that I didn't need to charge so much. I could exclude certificate of insurance, workers' comp, etc. Oh look, only because I like Ant, I'm willing to do this. If you sign a document that states the project is not dependent on its quality finish, I'll finish the job for you. No demo. I'll continue his work, but if you're not happy with the end results, there's nothing I can do for you. It'll be $6,000.
Bullcrap, I'm signing that! You have to do an amazing job and there is no way I'll give you more than $2,500. Maybe $3,000, if I love it.
I'm going to send over the two proposals. You can decide between the two choices I offered, or no deal, bud.
Okay, no deal. I can literally pay a Mexican at Home Depot $100 a day to do this. I just want to give Ant's guy some work.
If you're in a tight spot and you need some good quality work done, you're not entitled to anybody else's labor. They have every right to just offer you what they can do, and you can accept or reject it. Within the market, there's always going to be competing consumers, competing laborers, and competing employers. If you don't like the services that someone's offering, or you don't like their terms, you have to find someone else. And if you don't find anyone else, perhaps it's your standards that need to change. You are not entitled to anyone else's products or services. I don't get why suddenly everyone today woke up and said, "I need sour cream." We did. It just so happened everyone else in my town did too. And of course, once you've made the decision to pour glorified milk fat onto whatever you're eating, you naturally don't care for that light, reduced fat, or anything else they slap on the label to pretend this is somehow better for you. Look, I've made the decision to throw the least healthy thing on top of my already unhealthy dinner selection. I'm invested in my poor life choice. Nothing you're going to do will change that. And naturally, everyone else in the town feels the same way I do. So when I got to the sour cream and the awful sales they had, I was met with only light choices and nothing else. From cheap to overly priced, I had no choices. So I get on the ground and start digging in the back, on a wing and a prayer that behind one of these light choices, one sour cream fell behind that row, missing the depleted row where the regular sour cream is supposed to be. I go through every brand, every size, something. I don't care about price. This is for my dinner tonight, and because of the storms, if we lose power, I can still cook it because I can light the burners on a gas stove. And I find it. And just as I'm about to get up and put my precious find in the cart, I hear it. The sound of the little old lady, or choosing beggar in this case.
Excuse me, dear.
Yes?
I can't bend and I need a sour cream. A good one like you have. Do you think you can grab another?
I'm down here already, so what the heck, right? I could use some positive karma my way. I can look, sure, but I had to dig to find this one. I can't guarantee there's another one.
That would be great, honey, thank you.
So I'm going through everything, again. I couldn't find anything in the brand I had, but I did find a little misplaced one in the corner, hiding behind some cottage cheese. Hey, it's your lucky day.
Oh, thank goodness. Wait, this is...
Insert brand name.
Is it really?
I think the price was close to $4. Well, I can't find any others. I mean, this is it.
None in the cheaper brands you have? Or this?
Completely different brand.
I like this different brand best.
Me now getting up from the floor. Well, you saw me go through this all. That's the only one I can find.
Maybe in the back?
The back of what?
The store. You know, they have more product back there. They haven't gotten around to yet. Maybe you can look.
I don't work here. I can't just wander around the back looking for stuff.
But maybe you can call someone?
Call who? I'm sorry, I guess you can go to the customer service and maybe they can get someone. That's all I could find.
Can you look again?
Now I'm very obviously in a back brace. I had back surgery and possibly need more. It's not easy for me to get up and down, especially in stormy, rainy weather. I'm sorry, ma'am. You can see I have a bad back and knees too. I can't keep getting up and down. That's what I found. Maybe customer service.
You don't have any more in stock?
Me, really ready to scream. I don't work here. You can go to customer service. I really gotta go. I start to go.
Wait, really this brand is twice the price? I'm buying for several people, my kids, the grandkids. You know how it is when you get old.
I'm 36, lady. No, I don't know what it's like to be older than that. Insert long story about all her kids and grandkids, me politely nodding and whatever else. Wasn't really paying attention, looking at my watch, trying to do whatever it took to get the hint through that I wanted to leave. Choosing beggar, finally getting to the point of this.
With so many people to feed, I'm spending more than I already have.
Yeah, that sucks. Everything is so expensive.
Well, I hate to ask this. You've already helped so much. And I'm sure the brand I have tastes better than the store brand. A reward for your good work. We'll trade.
No, I'm sorry. I need to save money too.
But it's not like you couldn't have grabbed this one too. What would you have done if you had this brand in your cart and found the cheaper one looking for mine? Would you say I couldn't have it?
Honestly, probably. It wasn't easy going through all this twice. Consider it a reward for my efforts. You can try customer service.
That's very rude. I'm going to tell them how rude you are. Taking advantage of someone like me, you could have grabbed either one. I don't understand why you can't get that some people live on a fixed income. Where are you going? I'm going to tell you how rude you are to me. I'm going to tell everyone.
I just kept walking. I wanted to turn and tell her again I don't work here, so I don't know who they are that she's going to tell. I went out of my way enough. It's a $2 difference. I get the cheaper sour cream, regardless of if I found it first. I did. or second. The nerve of some people. I think it's easy to feel justified in your selfishness and project that selfishness onto other people when you can only see the situation that you're going through and you don't have compassion for anyone else. For the older woman, she could only imagine her situation, and there was no sense in which this younger person might be having a hard time either. The fact that they were in a back brace but still went and helped this person, and yet that wasn't good enough, shows that the older woman was the selfish person in this situation. Now, if they gave the cheaper sour cream to the older woman, would that have been a nice thing to do? Absolutely. But was the old woman entitled to it? Definitely not. I experienced this little gem this past holiday season, so I thought I'd post it for fun. I am going to tell you the saga of Excuse Me Lady. I still think of her fondly to this very day. Let me start with, 'twas 2 weeks before Christmas, and all through the store, not a creature was griping, except this entitled lady. So we're shopping at one of those membership box stores. You know, the kind where you pay a yearly fee for great deals on a crate of macaroni and cheese, that sort of thing. Well, we've done all of our shopping and we've come up to the registers. This store is designed to be half self-service registers. All the self-service registers have their own designated line, just like full-service registers, in which you line up for that particular register instead of entering one single, wrap-around line to empty out as registers open. We walk up and every single self-service lane is at least three shoppers deep, all except register 8. There is only one person queued up for that lane, because the person behind them suddenly decided to do more shopping and left the lane, and the person in front just left. How lucky can we be? So we cautiously line up behind the one person, waiting for Admiral Akbar to scream,
"It's a trap!"
Because hey, why didn't one of the others who was standing at least three deep in the other lines notice this? It's busy. The guy in front of us is actually paying for one item, and will be checking out long before they do. Then we figured out why. They were all on their cell phones, paying no attention to what was happening right beside them. One particular Karen, behind a customer with a huge purchase at register 9, is talking to someone most energetically and loudly about how rushed for time she is, how the slowpoke in front of her is holding her up, and how she has a dinner party that night and is already behind schedule. So, being an unwilling party to her conversation and trying to participate in some of that Christmas spirit, I motioned to her that she can get in front of us, to which she gave us the hand. Seriously, she gave us the palm forward, "stop talking to me, you peasant," gesture that usually infuriates me to no end. But I figured, hey, you're lost. And we wait out the last 30 seconds while the guy in front of us puts his card back in his wallet and puts his one purchase back in the buggy. So I scan my card and begin to scan my purchases as my husband hands them to me. It was then that we hear the voice of an absolute angel, one of the ones who got tossed into hell with Satan.
"Excuse me?"
I ignored it because I figured they were talking to someone else, until I heard it again, this time much louder and screechier.
"Excuse me?"
This time I turned. Are you talking to me?" Karen was still clutching her cell phone, one hand over the receiver, so they couldn't be deafened by the braying on the other end.
"Yes, I'm talking to you. We were in line first. You jumped in front of us. I'm telling a manager and having you banned from the store."
I rolled my eyes at her. "Ma'am, these lines are first come, first serve. Anyway, I tried to get you to jump in front of us and you ignored me. Held your hand up at us, remember? Better luck next time." And I turned my back to her. This is when she decided to march over to where we were standing. My husband stands well over 6 feet, so he's positioned himself between us, causing her to step back a bit, but it didn't stop her from flinging her spit-laden tirade.
"Excuse me, I'm a very important woman. I'm having a dinner party for my husband's co-workers. He owns a business. You need to take your things off the belt and let me check out. I was here first."
So being the good-hearted, warm, peace-loving human being that I am, I did the only thing that was right and good in this situation. I told her, "Yeah, no, not going to happen," and turned my back on her. And for the next 2 minutes, as we finish checking out, we hear this woman doing a combo bad-mouthing us on the cell phone, yelling at her husband for not saying something, and screaming, "Excuse me," at the top of her lungs to the customer service desk 20 feet away, trying to get one of them to abandon their post and kick me out. To no avail, they were all obviously ignoring her. We paid for our items, put our stuff back in the buggy, and walked off. But she heard us exclaim as we walked out of sight, "Excuse me," repeatedly, just to ruin her night. I'm sure we've all had to take that emergency call while we're at the register, but for most of us, we feel incredibly awkward because we understand the necessity to communicate to the cashier or the other people that might be around us. And being on the phone while other people need your attention is incredibly rude. This lady was straight up just on a social call. She was being rude and ignoring other people to her own detriment. They even offered her to cut in line in front of them because they recognized that she was busy and she was time poor. At least she claimed she was. Isn't it funny how the phrase "excuse me" is supposed to be a polite way of interjecting? And yet depending on the tone and the person who's saying it, it can make them sound like the rudest person.
"Excuse me, if you haven't subscribed to this channel, you should be subscribed right now. And excuse me, if you haven't hit that bell, hit that bell."
Submit your story to be read on the channel at voiceyhearstories@gmail.com and join our Voicey Veteran community at r/voiceyhear. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell to never miss an episode. All right, Voicey Veterans, I'll see you in the next one.